the Lord has promised good to me. His word, my hope secures. He will my share and portion me as long as life.
This every Sunday night, me and Steve has a program on Bible prophecy at 8 o'clock. We invite you to come and be with us, and we give you invitation to watch it. I believe that you'd enjoy it. So that's Sunday night at 8 o'clock. Also, we invite you to be with us at Lacy's Chapel. Go to Henry Crossing, go west, like you're going to Scottsboro, and the church is 3 miles on your left. From Henniger, you go west. It's Lacy's Chapel. We'd love to have you. And God is blessing our church. And we'd love to have you to come be with us at this church. If you don't have a church, I think that you would really enjoy it. And God is really blessing our church. And I believe that you'd enjoy it. So make that announcement real quickly. We're talking today about bearing fruit. And we was reading last week, just real quickly, in the 15th chapter of John, where Jesus said, I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purges it. And I said that means to clean or to purge. Or to prune, that it may bring forth more fruit. So, you know, God's will for us is to bear fruit. Then we go to Romans chapter 7 and talk about bearing fruit. It's God's will for us to bear fruit. Romans chapter 7. We go to Romans 7:4, and he said, wherefore, my brethren, also are become dead to the law by the body of Christ, that you should be married to another, even to him that raised the dead, that we should bring forth fruit unto God. So, you know, there's several of those verses. I just picked that one in Romans 7:4 that said we're to bear fruit in John 15. And it said we're to bring forth fruit unto God in Romans 7. Then we can look at Galatians chapter 5, where it says, the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. So Galatians 5, we talked about that last week, is the fruit of the Spirit, or it's what the Holy Spirit produces in the life of a believer. Then we can go to Ephesians. And this is what I want to, real quickly. Ephesians chapter 5, he says something here also. In Ephesians chapter 5, verse 9, he says, For the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness and righteousness and truth. So what Paul writes to the church of Ephesus, he's saying, the Holy Spirit in the life of a believer produces goodness, righteousness, and truth. So, Ephesians 5:9 says, the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness and righteousness and truth. And he's talking about what the Holy Spirit produces in the life of a believer is goodness, that which is good, righteousness, that which is righteous, It's what the Holy Spirit produces in the life of a believer, and truth. So, the Holy Spirit in the life of a believer produces goodness, righteousness, and truth. This is what the Holy Spirit produces in the life of a believer. Now I want to go real quickly to 1 John, chapter 5 of 1 John. And I want to read a verse from 1 John chapter 5, talking about, we're going to talk today a little bit about the Holy Spirit. 1 John chapter 5, he says, "For there are three that bear record in heaven, or bear witness in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one." He's talking about they come in agreement as one. Well, these are the three that by record in heaven are witness in heaven. The Father, the Word, Jesus in 1 John 1 is called the Word. In John 1, he's called the Word. The Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one. And these three are also God. There's God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. So these three are one. They're all part of the Godhead. These three make up the Godhead, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And, you know, it says we can go back to John, St. John, chapter 1 of St. John. And it says, "In beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God." Talking about Jesus, he's called the Word here. "And the Word was God." So it says in 1 John 5 and 7, there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, Jesus is called the Word, and the Holy Ghost. These three make up the Godhead. Well, it says in John, St. John 1 and 1, "In beginning was the Word," Jesus is called the Word here, "and the Word was with God," saying Jesus was with God, "and the Word," talking about Jesus, "was God." He's the Son of God. So we have God being called God. We have Jesus, the Son of God, being called the Word, said the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Jesus is called the Word. He's also called God in St. John 1 and 1. And we can go to the book of Acts. In the book of Acts, chapter 5 of the book of Acts, we can look at when Ananias and Sapphira, they lied unto Peter and kept back part of the money that, you know, they had property and they sold it, and he said, "Did you sell it for so much?" And they said, "Yes," and they lied. Well, here's what, they kept back part of the money. I mean, they just lied. And Peter said, "Ananias, why has Satan filled thy heart to lie to the Holy Ghost?" Now listen to what Peter said to Ananias. "Why has Satan filled thy heart to lie to the Holy Ghost? To keep back part of the price of the land." So Peter told Ananias, "Why has Satan filled your heart to lie to the Holy Ghost? While it remained, was it not thy own? And after it was so, was it not thy own power?" In other words, he said, you could have done anything you wanted to with the money. You didn't have to lie about it and keep back part of it. That's what he's telling me. "Why has thou conceived this thing in thy heart? Thou hast not lied unto men, but unto God." So Peter tells Ananias, when you lied to the Holy Ghost, you lied to God. So we see that the Holy Ghost is called God in Acts 5 and 4. Jesus is called God in St. John 1 and 1. And of course, we know that God is called God. So you have these three in the Godhead. We have the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost are in the Godhead. And we have these different scriptures, and each one of them calls each member of the Godhead God. Well, they're part of the Godhead. There's the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Okay. So, why I really wanted to stress that, Jesus is called God in St. John 1 and 1. The Holy Ghost is called God in Acts 5 and 4. And, of course, God is called God in John, St. John 1 and 1. Well, we have these three that make up the Godhead. And each one of them is called God, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. Then you go to John chapter 8. Now, I'm going to show you something. This is really good here. Then John chapter 8. John 8 and verse 37. John chapter 8. Which Jesus is talking about. John 8 and 38, I speak that which I have seen with my Father, and you do that which you have seen with your Father. So we see here that Jesus is talking about being with God in eternity. That verse is referring to Jesus being with God in eternity. So we have all these verses. It's talking about the Holy Spirit or the Holy Ghost being with God. Verse 26 of the 14th chapter of John, Jesus said, "But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance whatsoever I have said unto you." So Jesus is talking about the Holy Ghost. He's called the Comforter or the Helper. You know, when Jesus was with us, with the disciples, he was their Comforter. He was their Helper. But when he left, he said, "But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name." Jesus said, "My Father is going to send you another helper or another Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, and he shall teach you all things." So, you know, we're talking about bearing fruit here, but Jesus is talking about God, his Father. You know, Jesus said, "It's expedient for you that I go away." The word expedient means advantageous. Jesus said it was for our advantage that he went away, or he went back to the Father. He said, "It's expedient for you that I go away. If I go not away, the Comforter will not come." Talking about the Holy Ghost. So Jesus told those disciples, "It's to your advantage that I go back to the Father, because if I don't go back to the Father, he will not send the Holy Ghost." So, if we understand this, how important that the Holy Ghost is in the life of a believer. Jesus said, "It's to your advantage that I go back to my Father." That's what he told the disciples. "It's to your advantage. If I go not away, the Comforter will not come." Jesus was putting the emphasis on the Holy Ghost. Well, it says right here, "But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, which the Father will send in my name." Jesus said who sent the Holy Ghost to us was God. God sent the Holy Ghost. First, he sent Jesus to us. And when Jesus went back to the Father after his resurrection, 50 days later on the day of Pentecost, God sent the Holy Ghost. The word Pentecost means 50. 50 days later, Jesus sent the Holy Ghost. God sent the Holy Ghost. So we understand that the Holy Ghost is from God. He is part of the Godhead. This is really important that we understand that who we have living inside of us is the Holy Spirit or the Holy Ghost, and He is part of the Godhead. We have God in us. We have God living in us, or the Holy Spirit, which is part of the Godhead, living inside of us. He said, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, He shall teach you all things. Well, now listen. Listen to what I'm going to say to you. Jesus said that the teacher which teaches us is the Holy Ghost. The one that, when Jesus was here, He taught the people. But when He went away, He said, I'll send you another Comforter. I'll send you another Helper. And He will teach you all things. But do we understand that the Holy Ghost was part of the Godhead? In Acts 5:4, He's called God. In John 1:1, God is called God. Jesus is called God. In Acts 5:4, the Holy Ghost is called God. So we have God living us, in us, God the Holy Spirit that lives inside of us. He said, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, God sent Him. You know, the Holy Ghost is not someone to be afraid of. He's part of the Godhead. You don't have a better friend than the Holy Ghost. It's not somebody to be afraid of, to be fearful of. You don't have a better friend. He is your Comforter. He is your Helper. He said, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, He shall teach you all things. You know, we have to have the Holy Ghost. He is the one that teaches us. He is the one in us that reveals these spiritual truths unto us. Jesus called Him the teacher. He shall teach you all things. You know, the Holy Ghost is so amazing if we understand that the third part of the Godhead lives inside of us, and He takes these spiritual truths, He takes the Word of God, and He reveals them unto us. He reveals them unto us. I mean, God has given us teachers. God has given us preachers and teachers. But the real teacher is the Holy Ghost. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, He shall teach you all things. He shall teach you all things. Jesus said the Holy Ghost is the teacher. And bring all things to your remembrance, whatever I have said unto you. Jesus not only told them the Holy Ghost was going to teach them spiritual things, but He said He's going to work with your memory. Well, this is so good right here. And He will bring back to your memory all the things that I have said unto you. Well, that's why the Bible said the natural man receiveth not the things of God, neither can he know them, because they're spiritually discerned. If the Spirit of God is not in a person, and He is revealing these spiritual truths to a person, they do not understand the Bible. They will never understand the Bible. It takes the Spirit of God in a person to reveal these spiritual truths as the Bible. The Bible said the natural man receiveth not the things of God. The Bible said a lost person cannot read the Bible and understand it. A lost person cannot understand Scripture. That's why we've had all these scientists and all these educated people saying the Bible was written by monkeys and all this, it makes no sense. Well, it does it to the natural man. The Bible says it don't. The Bible is a spiritual book. Jesus said, my word is spirit. It is a spiritual book, and it has to be understood by the Spirit. And for you to understand it by the Spirit of God has to reveal it to you. The Holy Ghost is the teacher. He is the one that teaches us. I mean, this is all good right here. John 14:17. Here's what Jesus said. If you love me, keep my commandments. And listen to what Jesus said. And I will ask the Father, I will pray the Father, that word there means to ask. I will ask the Father, and he shall give you another comforter. You know, while Jesus was here, he was comfort to them. He was helping them. He instructed them. He taught them. He taught, you know, he defended them. He fed them, But he said, I'm going to ask the Father, and he's going to give you another comforter. Well, for you to have another comforter, you have to have been comforted at one time or another to have another one. Well, Jesus was the original comforter. He came and helped them. He taught them. He fed them. He walked with them. He encouraged them. But he said, I'm going to send you another comforter. And the notes in my Bible said the word comforter means helper. God said, I'm sending someone that's going to help you. You don't have to live life alone. I'm going to send someone that will help you. The Holy Ghost is our helper. He is who God has sent, and he lives inside of us, and he is our helper. Now listen what he said, that he may abide with you forever. Jesus said this helper, talking about the Holy Ghost, that he may abide. The word abide there means continue with or to dwell with you forever. This is what Jesus said, the Holy Ghost, he is there permanently. He is there to abide with you forever, to dwell with you. He is your helper. You know, we are never alone. If you have the Holy Ghost living inside of you, you're never alone. You're never walking alone. But verse 17 says this, even the Spirit of truth. You know, Jesus called the Holy Ghost the Spirit of truth. Jesus called the Holy Ghost the Spirit of truth. What he taught, he was the third part of the Godhead. And he still is the third part of the Godhead. What he taught come from God. Jesus said about the Holy Ghost, he does not speak of himself, but what he shall hear, that shall he declare unto you. Jesus said the Holy Ghost wasn't just teaching on his own, but what he heard from God, that was what he declared. You know, it's amazing that God has given us a teacher that we can read the Word of God, and he will help us to understand it. But he's called the Spirit of Truth. The Holy Ghost will tell you what is truth. He will reveal the truth to you. You don't. If the Holy Ghost reveals something to you, you don't have to worry about whether or not it's the truth. If the Holy Ghost reveals it to you, it's truth. Jesus called him the Spirit of Truth. He called him the Spirit of Truth. He called him the Holy Ghost. He called him the Holy Spirit. And he called him the Spirit of Truth. He also called him our Comforter. So we understand that when the Holy Ghost lives inside of us, that is God living inside of us. Acts 5 and 4, he's called God. We have God living inside of us. God, the Holy Spirit, lives inside of us. He said, even the Spirit of truth, which the world cannot receive. He's not in a lost person. He cannot be in a lost person. He is only in God's children. The Bible said the world cannot receive him till they confess their sins and ask Jesus to come into their heart. Then they can receive him. But he's not living. The Holy Spirit is not dwelling in lost people. He said, whom the world cannot receive because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. You know, a lost person, they go by what they see, touch, smell, see, hear, the five senses. But a child of God is to be led by the Spirit. The child of God is to be taught and to be led by the Spirit of God, which dwells in them. You have another helper. You have another comforter. He's called the Holy Ghost. Here's what he said. Neither can know him. A lost person don't know the Spirit of God. A lost person don't understand the Word of God. But they can if they'll ask Jesus into their heart. You may be watching. You may be lost. You say, I want this helper. I want this comforter. I want to understand the Word of God. If you'll ask Jesus into your heart, say, Jesus, come into my heart. Forgive me of my sins. I asked you to be my Lord and Savior. And if you say that and you mean it, the Bible says he'll come into your heart. But he says right here, neither can he know them. Jesus said, but you know him. Well, the Bible said his spirit will bear witness with our spirit. Jesus told the disciples, but you shall know him. Called the Holy Ghost a person. Called him a him. He's not some cloud floating around or some spirit floating around. He is a person. Jesus said, but you shall know him. And that's what Jesus said about the Spirit of God. You'll know him. When he comes to dwell in you, you'll know it. For he shall dwell with you. Now listen what Jesus said about the Spirit of God. For he shall dwell with you, and he shall be in you. That's what Jesus said. He's going to dwell with you, and he's going to be in you. He's going to dwell with you, and he's going to be in you. Well, now we can understand that verse. Jesus said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. I'll be with you always. Well, if the Spirit of God is dwelling in you, he's with you and he's in you, it don't matter where you go. He's there. It don't matter if you're going through hard times, he's there. If you're going through good times, he's there. There's a, in the old Redback Hymnal, there's a song. It's a very old song. The name of it is I'm Never Alone. You know, it says, I'm never alone. No, never alone. Well, that's true. You're not. If God's Spirit is living inside you, and he said he don't speak of his own, but he speaks which he heareth. The Spirit of God reveals spiritual truths to you as God gives it to him. So, you know, this is, we've been talking about bearing fruit, but we spent longer on this than I meant to, but you have a helper that helps you. You have a helper that teaches you. You have a helper that encourages you. And he's called the Holy Spirit, and he lives inside of you. He is with you. You know, you may be going through, you may be watching, you may be going through some tough times, but he's there. He's not leaving you. Jesus said that he may abide with you forever. He's not here today and gone next week and coming back next week after next. He's there. But I want to say this. If someone is watching and you never asked Jesus to come into your heart and you want to be born again, I want to pray real quickly. And I want you to pray with me. Say, Father, I ask you to forgive me of my sins and come into my heart. Say, Lord, I make you my Lord and Savior. And say, Jesus, I ask you to come in. And it's that simple. We make it hard, but it's that simple. And if you've asked him to come in, just start thanking him, start praising him for coming in. And if you need a book, and if I can help you, call me. Any way that I can help you, I'll get you something to get you started. To this time next week, get a chance. Come be with us at Lacy Chapel. We'd love to have you. To this time next week, may God bless you, and goodbye.